Hi, I'm Helle, and today we are going to play Sagrada, and I'm joined by David from Australia. And first I will explain a little bit about the rules, but you can also follow along and learn the rules in that way. First we have to set up the game, and we each have our own board, and we will get two of these where we have to choose one. And in Sagrada we have to make our windows with colored dice. And I will give us each one. Oh, you will get two. And then you have to choose one. But before we choose this one, we need to get a goal. We will each get a goal. We have five cards with the five different colored dice. And we will each get one of these cards. And the die pips we collect with this color will score us points at the end of the game. So we would like to get high numbers with this color that we each get. And they can give you a lot of points. So Dave, you will get one. And I will get one. And this is the only secret thing that is in this game. This is this card. So I will close my eyes and let you see your card. Are you ready
okay.
for that?
So yeah? which side am I? I'm on that side, am I?
No, you're on this side. You're on this side. So David, I should have put names for us, I guess. And now we have just added our names. So David, he will be playing this side and I will be playing this side. And David, he needs to know what his secret goal is, what he can score points for. And I will close my eyes and you can get to see what your goal is, David. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Can you see it fine? You should be able to see a color.
I can see a color.
You got it?
I can actually read that, which is good.
So?
Yep, I know what it is.
Perfect. So we will just place it here and I will look at mine. Maybe you should close your eyes so viewers, they can see what I have. Yes. Then you can open your eyes again. This is helpers we will get in the game. Move any one of your die in your window, ignoring restrictions. So you can move a number 3 to a number 1, if you bribe this one. And you can bribe this one with one of these. So the first person to bribe it will only have to use one of these. And the second person, if there's already a, what do you call this, a tile on here, will have to use 2 to bribe. And all others would have to use 2 to bribe this card and use the effect. The same goes with these, but they are just different helps we can get. Okay, this one is actually the same as the other one. Move any one die in your window, ignoring color restrictions. So we have one where you can ignore the numbers and one where you can ignore the color. Both helpful.
And easy to remember, which is
yes,
good.
They are pretty easy. And then we have this one. After drafting, we can increase or decrease the value of the drafted die by 1. And we may not change a number 6 to a number 1. So if we have a number 4, we can make it to a number 3 or a number 2 if we bribe this card. So I think we will place these cards here. So this is cards that can help us during the game. And then we have our objectives. What we can score points for at the end of the game. And with this objective, we need to make columns with different numbers. And it doesn't have to be, it can be 5 and 6s too. We just need 4 different numbers in a column. For each of those, we can score 4 points to the max of 5 points if we have different numbers on all our columns, these columns. Yes.
Sorry, so you get 4 points for every column.
Every
so
column where you have different numbers.
So I can get a maximum of 20 points there
exactly.
Just from that one card.
Yeah, and that's okay. Impressive if you can do that. And then we have this one where you will, for each diagonal color, diagonally color, diagonally, you will score 1 point. So in this case, there are four blue that are diagonally, and there are three of the yellow.
Okay, and it's it doesn't have to be a diagonal that goes all the way across, though.
Just if you have two, with this one, you would have 1, 2, 1, 2. So it just have to be the same color diagonally. And with this one, we can collect sets of 1 and 2s, and it will score 2 points for each set. So you have, if you have 5 number 2 and 4 number 1, then you have 4 sets, and it would be 8 points. Back to selecting these, because these are important if, compared to what you are going for. Because you might want to, now you don't have any that actually are diagonally on this, on these boards. Sometimes you will have some that are already going diagonally in a color, and then you might want to choose that one. So you have to choose one side of these.
I'll take the 4 dot, which is on the other side.
This is this one.
Yeah, I'll go for.
So we will discard the other easiest one, and then you will get 4 of these. And we will pop it in here. And then I have to select something. So I have these two sides, and I have these. Maybe I think I will use this one. And do I want to take the really easy one, or do I want to take the harder one? I'll take the harder one, just for the fun of it. And I will get 5 of these tokens. And in the game, David, I think you should be the start player. So I will draft 5 dice. You will draft 2 dice per player, and then 1 extra die.
Good, because you'll have to guide me for the first few turns.
Yes.
As,
so what will happen now is that David, you will select 1 of the dice and place to your board. And when you place to your board, you have to, the first die have to be on the edges, on the borders. You have to place them in one of these spaces. And the next die you build have to be connected to the other die. And it can be diagonally. So if you place a die here, you may place the second one there, there, or there. And if you place a die there, then you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spaces where you can place a die. And when you place a die to the board, you may not have 2 of the same colors adjacent to each other. You can have 2 of the same colors diagonally, but not adjacent. And the same goes with the same kind of number. So you can't have 2 of the same numbers beside each other. So if I had a green die here, I can't have a green die there, 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 and there. And if I placed a number 4, I can't have a number 4 on any of these spots either. Yes? Does that make sense?
Okay, so that's my the only word I use in board gaming, orthogonal, isn't it? It's the
orthogonal.
So you can have a diagonal. You can have a diagonal, but you can't have an orthogonal, which
orthogonal
means
I always have a problem pronouncing that word, but when you say it, I can say it too.
So sort of north, south, east, west, basically. You can't do it there, yeah, but you can do it diagonally.
Yeah.
We have a it's our favorite gaming word. We tend to overuse it because it's such a, I don't use it anywhere else in the world.
Me neither.
In gaming, neither. Orthogonal.
And I normally avoid saying the word.
That's a great sound.
Orthogonal. Something like that.
Orthogonal, yes.
Orthogonal. Okay. Yeah. So you can choose a die.
The green 6 looks good, actually.
Yes.
I'll jump on that.
And where do we want to place it?
Down the bottom where the 6 spot is.
Yeah. It's a good thing to cover up the restrictions you have. But then, and what will happen now, then it's my turn. I will choose a die and I will choose my second die, and then you get to choose your last die. And if we were four players, then all players would choose a die, and the last player would choose a die, and you will go backwards to the start player. So the start player will always choose the first and the last die. So I will have to choose two then. I think I will start down here with a red and a yellow. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe not in any way. We have the rule with the... Okay, maybe I will do another thing then. I think I will place this one there. No. I'm already in trouble.
I'm willing to accept your conceding, and I'll take the game as a victory, if that's okay.
But I think, okay, I will say I won't get five different numbers in that row. I have so many restrictions, so I think I need to use some of these dice when I can.
Could you go on the corner with the yellow corner, and you got the two next to it, so you could do
that? Yeah, I could.
Oh, no, because it's the same color.
Exactly.
The same color orthogonally.
Yes, it is. that no go. Then you may choose a color.
Okay. Well, it doesn't help my restrictions, so that was very cruel of you. I'll place the three next to the six, green six, under the five.
Yes. And this one will go up here for the first round. We have 10 rounds. We'll play the game in 10 rounds.
And so then, I'll call that D1, if that's better. It's like a battleship. Yeah.
I was just thinking about us having a start player token.
Oh, no, 1D, sorry. That'd be all... One road D. Anyway.
I think I will take this one as the start player token from Hive.
Ah, yes, so. Rub it in. I'm sure people can go back and see the Hive lesson that you gave me a while back. Hive lessons, plural.
Yeah.
That's psychological warfare. That's,
I'm starting now.
Just having that there for the entire game. That's evil.
Oh, sorry. But, you know. Then I think I will take number four, purple. And you can choose two. Look at that. You can get all your restrictions fulfilled here.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Thanks. I never thought of that.
There's two number ones and a number five.
So, and it also, by going across, it gives me far more chance, doesn't it?
So you have more places.
I'll put the red five at 2D. Is that what we're calling it? The second row from the bottom and four across.
Yeah, it could be.
And so do I go blue or yellow? Does that impact you in any way?
I got
maybe if
options.
I take... Yeah. You've got too many options. I'll take the blue... white one. Sorry, blue one.
I did a mistake. Oh, good thing we have one we can bribe up here.
Ah. Okay. Yes, you're right. I didn't even notice it.
I won't be able to make a number four there. Good thing we have one we can bribe.
Sorry, so what's the rule if you accidentally discover it?
I haven't done anything wrong yet, but I just can't place a number four here because I can't have two number fours beside each other.
Right, that's the rule, isn't it? Okay,
good thing I can move a die and ignore the number restriction.
Ah, good
so
idea.
So if I bribe this one, I can put another number here. Doesn't matter.
Or could you move the four?
Ooh, there? And then I could also do that with that one. Oh. Yeah.
I'm glad you picked it up.
I can move a die, and then ignore the number restriction. I think I'm going to need that one at some point.
That's coming back to me. This is a game. Yeah, this is a game where it is, but how, no matter how look you stare at it, you do end up doing mistakes like that, don't you?
You can.
I'll go for the blue one. The blue one on the one restriction next to the six, diagonally to the six.
But then I could put a number four here because I know I want to change that number. Yeah, I think I will do that. Now I have messed it up. I can just mess it even more up, right? And you will be the start player for the next round. You will get 5 new dice.
Yeah.
Oh, too many.
Can I put my beetle on top of that queen? Is that possible?
You can try.
We're going to merge the two games. We can do.
Yeah. Sagrada Hive.
The Sagrada Hive. Look, I'm sure mashup is going to be the next board game theme, isn't it? Where everyone's run out of ideas, so we'll combine the, you know, we'll the Settlers of Carcassonne or something like that. All these crossover. That'd be the Settlers of Carcassonne, the dice game, something like that. Okay, yeah. I got to take a die. So, So what are the rules again? So it's the columns, the diagonals, and ones and twos. So ones. Yeah. That's
none of us have made this one yet.
But is that a yellow one?
Yeah, a yellow one and a yellow five. Oh, yeah, it can be hard to see because it's transparent.
I can't put it there. Oh, I don't have many choices, do I? I will put the... That's a terrible roll. actually, I'll put the... green four on my four restriction.
Yeah. Then I have to choose two.
Oh, sorry. That's okay.
Was it there you wanted it?
Yeah, what is there a four under that one? No, I was thinking another one.
It is a number four. It is a number four.
Oh, but actually, I think the green, you played it much better. I'll go back to the green. The only way I can win is with your help.
And I didn't even notice it.
Because that helps with all the different numbers, doesn't it? So that's a good idea.
What do I want to take then? I have to think of my restrictions this time. Yeah. Yeah, I think I will take a number five die. Yeah, I will place it up here. And then I will place a number six. There. Yeah. We are not completing this one where we are getting the diagonal colors.
Yeah, I've completely ruined the diagonals here.
Me too.
So I can legally... That's a red five, isn't it? I'm just...
This is a purple.
Purple?
Purple.
Oh, okay. That's unclear here. Yeah, I guess the purple in the purple spot would be great. Thank you.
See, we got a lot of yellow dice up here. Then I will take the start player. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Both the number threes are a wrong color for me. But I have a number one I can use there. I think I will just take the number one and place in this space.
So I'll take the yellow three and stick it on the three restriction.
Yes. And you get to choose one more die.
And I'll take the red two. I'll get my first attempt at a diagonal and place it on the other two.
On this one?
Yeah, that would be great.
I can place a number two there. There. Yeah, let's just place a number two. There. So we got all the yellow dice up here. So.
It's a nice game, Sagrada. It's really.
It is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah.
The only thing, playing it physically, I always thought the boards and the dice were probably a little bit too small. It'd be nice to have a version a lot bigger.
But I guess you can easily, when you have to manipulate some of them, you can push to the others so they will turn over.
Yeah, but I guess it'd be much more expensive because you're going to have larger dice and boards. But it'd be amazing they haven't done. Maybe they have like an XL version or something.
I played one at Essen, but that was with the giant dice.
just the large. Standard size.
Yeah, I know what you mean. So you could have a normal size die.
Yeah, I mean watching it's fantastic, but I think that the actual physical thing that's just a bit too tiny. I've got fat hands, so it doesn't really help.
Well, in this case, I'm moving the dice for you.
Yeah, it's great. It's, what do we got? They're two purples, aren't they? Yeah.
Yeah, two purples and a number two yellow.
Okay, so I'll take the two purple and stick it orthogonally next to the blue one, please. On the side.
There? There?
Yeah, yes, please.
Is it down Thank in the you. Corner?
No, orthogonally to the one. Word for the day.
Oh dear. I will never get it, I guess. Let me just take the number 5 and should I take the number 6 or one more number 5? I think I will just go for one more number 5. So I got lots of 5s. Yeah, that's it.
I'll take the purple 6 and we'll put it on the, I guess the way I see it, top row. So fourth across, or so 4D. That's what we've got a system.
Is that where? There or there?
Yeah.
There.
Yeah, that's perfect. No. The other one. Yeah. So that way I get all 4 different numbers.
Oh, yep. So it was the right place. Have to remember the delay you have. Okay.
Ah, yes, you're right. There's a slight delay. You're probably in the right spot.
And a yellow die again up here. That's funny. One, two, three, four, and then one more. Yeps. What do we want this time? Again, a yellow number 3. That's annoying.
Is that a 3 or a 2?
It's a 3. Oh, okay. Number 3.
Okay.
Well, let's just fill in this spot down here with a number 6.
So I will take the yellow 3 and put it on the yellow.
There?
Yep.
Yep.
And the blue 5 on the blue square.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, I can do that.
Wow. And I have a number 6 and a number 1 in red. That one is red.
So the action cards, do they replace a turn, or are they an addition? You do that on your turn?
You just do it on your turn, depending on what it says. So I'm considering using some of these at the moment.
Okay, all good.
Because I have made a mess over here. I need to fix it somehow.
Fix the 4.
Yeah, I need to fix it. And so I'm considering my options. And I'm not that happy with what I have made so far in the game. But I think I might just want to fix it on the next turn. On the next turn. So for now, I will just take a number 1 red die. And then we will see what will come up, if I will use some of these abilities up here.
Well, at least that's the first non-yellow die we've put in the discard. It's amazing, had that run of 5.
Ooh.
And still more come out.
Okay, I need the green die. Yeah. I think I will take the number 1 die and place here.
So I will take the green 5 and place it in the corner of the, what's that? That's bottom row E.
Yeah.
Yes, please.
And you get to choose one more.
I'll take the 4. Well, and put that in the gap just above that green 5.
Yeah.
No, sorry. So the green 5.
Oh, down.
Where the one I just placed. There's the gap. There.
Number 4. There. Oh, you're going for it. Oh, I'm just looking at the mess I've made, how I can get myself out of it. But at the moment, I think I'll just take this one. And we get one more up here.
Another yellow.
Yeah.
Another yellow.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3. That was 4, 5.
Interesting game. I've only played this I think once before, but that was with 4 people. But it works quite nice with 2.
It does.
Oh wow,
does.
Lots of 1s and 2s.
And it's also challenging playing solo. You can play it solo too. Yeah, only 1s and 2s.
I'll take one of the, and they're the same color and number combination as well. Really interesting.
Exactly.
I'll put the purple 2 and shove it right in the little hole there.
Right in
above
here.
Above the green 6.
Whoops. It also matches perfectly. Well, I'm definitely going to take this one down there. And I've made a terrible game here, I think. Okay.
Great choice left.
Yeah, just considering if I can undo some of the mess I've made.
Well, you did go for the hard one, so I assume that's why you get the extra beads.
Yeah, I think I will again move a die so I can ignore the color restriction. Well, not the number restriction. No, I can't. And it's the same color as that one. Then I would have to move that one, and that would be stupid. I'm in trouble in this game.
Is it worth filling that hole? Because it's so hard to fill it.
No, I'm just
hole.
Thinking because I have two fives, two ones, two twos. So I'm at the moment not really going for anything. So I'm thinking of if I could move some stuff, so I could perhaps.
Oh, okay, fair enough. Yeah, that makes
good something.
Sense.
But I think I will just bribe the one where I can ignore the color restriction. But there aren't any color, but I would just like to move this one down there. So I at least get something connected, and I have the possibility of getting different numbers on the row.
What was the color restriction? I missed
just
the color
Just that
restriction.
You can place, you don't have to mind about the color when you move.
Okay, but which
die.
One did you place?
I took this one and placed down here.
But there's no color restrictions.
Nope, there aren't. So I guess I can just move it. Because I can ignore,
oh, yeah, yeah, sorry,
I can ignore
sorry,
the color restrictions, but there aren't any restrictions.
No, no, no. Yeah. Sorry, no, I didn't realize you took it from somebody. Yeah, that's okay.
I guess so.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's fine. I mean, it's saying you can move it, and if there was a color restriction, you
can ignore it.
Ignore it. But you can still move it.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. Well, you can get a number one.
Yeah, I will go there in the corner. I'll put the one there.
And then
Thank
I'll
you.
Just start here. See what we can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wow.
Are there any orange dice in the bag? Like, I've got none on, and you've got one.
Oh, yeah, the red. These?
Well, the red dice, yeah. It's very strange. I've only got one
yeah,
each.
Yeah, but we got a lot of yellow. Okay. Oh. Then. What can I do? I would like a number 3, and it has to be a red die. A red number 3. So I will use one more up here, where I can take a die and turn it. So I will make this number 2 to a number 3, and then I can place it on that spot. Hey, I got my first row with different numbers! Woohoo!
I'm in trouble here.
Yeah, you can place a die down there. But then you are in trouble. So you might have to bribe someone up here.
Yeah, I think I will. So I will place... Let's place the 3 down on the bottom row.
Yes.
Okay, so what choices have I got? I've got.
You can ignore the. No, you can't. Yeah, you can ignore the number. No, you can't, because they can't be placed. So the only place you can place it is one up at the red space if you ignore the color restriction.
So, okay, so I'll do the ignore the color restriction, but which one do I put there? I will put the. The 5.
And I will take the number 6 and place there. So I got 2 rows now.
You got 2 blanks as well. I should have covered that 4 earlier. I've sort of had it hanging there.
Okay, you still have, you can bribe, so you can ignore the color, the number restriction. So you should be fine.
I guess I'm fortunate. I'm lucky I get first choice as well.
Yeah.
If there was a four, it'd be really good.
That's true. Oh, you can also bribe the one where you can change the number, one up or one down.
Ah. That would be perfect.
Yeah.
I'll bribe the guy to get the five down one.
And that will just cost these.
And that will go on the four.
I wanted that number five.
Yeah, I'm not playing this smart enough where I'm looking at your one trying to work out what you need.
But I can definitely... Let me see. Can I do something with my last bribe so I can do something? Because I can't take two dice here, so I have different numbers here. But could I do something so I could get even more? No. Because then I would want one of these fives to go away, but they both have a color restriction. Then I have a number one. It has to be a number one. And I have that one. I can't place any of the others there, so I can't do that. Nothing smart to do in that situation. Nope. I think I'll just take a... number six and a number three. By the way, each of these is worth 1 point at the end of the game if you haven't used them. Just remembered.
Is that a two or a three?
It's a two.
Yellow?
It's a two.
Two, okay. Yeah, it's,
so you
it's
can
quite look, tricky though.
Yeah, you can place it. And you even get these connected. So that's
three
points.
Diagonals, yeah.
Yeah.
And I get my... no repeat number as well. So I'll definitely take the two.
So you have actually managed to make no repeat numbers on all of them?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're going to beat me in this game, David.
I don't know.
Yeah, you are.
I'm just waiting for your bug to come and land on top of the queen.
That
and claim
was
the
last round.
I know it's going to work. So.
So we will go to the scoring. It was funny how many yellow dice that went out here.
Yeah, it's pity my secret power card had nothing to do with yellow dice.
Yeah, mine actually did, but it was really low numbers, and I have had all the restrictions that I have to fulfill.
Yeah, mine was on green dice, which was pretty lousy.
Yeah, I did better in green, actually, you can see. Well, we start with our colors, and you have... 15 points on the green.
Oh, sorry, it's not the number, it's the total. Okay, oh.
Yeah, it's
the
total.
That was not intended.
No.
stumbling blindly to a win.
And I have 17.
Oops. Okay. Oh, that was lucky.
And then I can just take 2 points for these. One of them. It's worth a point when you don't use them. But then you are going to take me in this one, David. Let's just start with me. Terrible. I got 1, 2, 3. These two, I have 2 ones and 2 fives. So I only have 3 columns, so I will get 12 points. So it will be 31. And David, you managed to make them all. So you have 20 points.
Yeah, a bit lucky there.
So 35. Oh, mine was there. 31. I placed it on a wrong spot. Okay, then we have the diagonalies. And if we start over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Sorry, how am I on 31?
Not you, me. You're there.
Oh, okay.
You're on 35.
Oh, I can't even see. Okay, good.
I'm on 31.
That makes sense. That's only... we'll be behind.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I got 8. And that is 39. And you have got, wow. Whoa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Also 8.
So you count the diagonals, I'm not clear, so you got...
Yeah, I am. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Is it that?
No, so no, you've got two, it's you ten. Have two more. 10, these two. So you have 10.
So you got the two reds.
The two reds.
And then you've got the...
Five.
Oh, because you don't double count the yellows there, do you? Or do you?
No, no, nothing is double counted. You got three.
Right, okay, so...
Three.
Perfect. Okay.
And five.
Four, five.
And two.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
So you got up to 45.
Yeah. So I got 10 points.
And
that
then
makes sense.
You have two number ones, and a lot of twos. So you have this two times. So that's 4 points. Just up at 49. And what do I have? I have the same. I have two twos just and four ones. So that is also 4 points. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you definitely won this one, David.
That's I think that's my first win ever.
Yeah.
Yippee.
But I started wrong and then, yeah, it does win.
Yeah.
Went terrible wrong. I had to try to come back from it again.
But yeah, that's hard, isn't it? I guess that you're always behind the eight ball with that four thing, because then it's you're so narrowed down with your manipulations as well.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, but that's also when you take the harder ones, then you have not as much freedom as where you want to place your tiles or your dice in the game. But yeah, really enjoy
it's
this.
It's a great game. I really enjoy this. Again, yeah. It's the dice are small when I use fingers. I just always keep knocking them over it. But the game mechanics, lovely. It's really nice. Do like
but
it.
They could make a little bit of a bigger version of the game.
Yeah.
Especially when you need to take someone out here, you can knock the others over.
Yeah, slightly using like standard size dice with maybe a little bit of gap.
Bigger gap between them.
Especially because the aesthetic of the stained glass window would look even better with a bigger board.
Yeah.
You know, it looks nice.
It does look nice.
It's almost like this is the travel version of the real version.
Yeah. They could make a bigger version. Yeah. So
thank you, Helle. That was fantastic. That was really good. Enjoy your time, taking the time to play for someone at completely different time zones.
Yeah, you are the hardest one to make time with playing because you are on the opposite side of the world. And when it's
it's for those watching, it's 10:30 p.m. now, and it's what would that be? It's 2:30 your time.
Half past two. Half past two.
So thank you for spending a little of your afternoon playing games. It's fantastic.
You're welcome, David. Always a pleasure. And congratulations with your win.
I know. Well, that's it. I'm not going to play ever again now. we're calling it a draw. That's it. You're only good as your last game, that type of thing. That's But thank you very much.
You're welcome, Dave. Well, it would be boring not playing again just because you won a game, Dave. But thanks for the game, David.
Okay, bye.
Bye.